Welcome to our channel Learning Math. In this video, we're going to learn about power. What's the meaning of power? What are the main rules of power? How did we get these rules? We're going to prove them and solve applications on them. Now let's start together. First, let's remember what's the meaning of times. If we have, for example, 3 times 5, it's like 3 plus 3, 5 times, or 5 plus 5, 3 times. Well, what happens if we multiply a number by itself instead of adding it? Here we talk about what we call the power. For example, 3 power 5 is 3 times 3 times 3, 5 times. Also, 5 power 3 is 5 times 5 times 5, 3 times. Here we talk about power. Well, something which is very important. When we say 3 power 5, the number that is written below is said to be the base. This base represents the number that we should multiply by itself. Well, the number that is written here is said to be the power or exponent. It's written up to the base at the right. It's smaller, sure, than the base. We call it power, exponent, or index. What does it represent? It represents how many times should we multiply this base by itself. So in general, as a general form, a power m represents a times a several times, m times. A is the base, m is the power or exponent or index. Well, example, 10 power 4 is 10 times 10, 4 times it's 10,000. Note something here, we have 4 zeros. Also, the power of 10 is 4. When we talk about the power of 10, the number of zeros will be equal to the power of 10. Here, 5 power 2 is 5 times 5, so it's 25. 2 power 3, we multiply 2 by itself 3 times, it's 8. Also, here, 7 power 1, for example, how many 7s should we have? We have 1 7, so it's equal to 7. Here, it's a rule. A power 1 is equal to A. Well, something we should keep in mind. Squared numbers are numbers raised to the power 2. Here, for example, 5 square is 5 times 5 equals 25, 4 square, 4 times 4, 16, 7 square is 7 times 7, 49. We should keep in mind an important example for squared numbers, the area of a square. Isn't it side times side? So it's side square. What about the cube numbers? Cube numbers are raised to the power 3. For example, 5 is 3 is 5 times 5 times 5, 3 times, it's 125. 3 cube, for example, is 3 times 3 times 3, 27. 10 power 3, note it here, 10 times 10 times 10 is 1000. Power 3, we have 3 zeros for 10 equal to the power. Well, also when we talk about cube numbers, we should keep in mind the volume of a cube. It's a times a times a, so it's a power 3. Well, now we're going to start by the main rules in power. When we have the same base, for example, here 3 power 2 times 3 power 3. If we have times between them, we should add the powers. Why? How it comes? Let's solve it together. 3 power 2, isn't it 3 times 3? Times, we copy it. 3 power 3, isn't it 3 times 3? 3 times? Well, look at them right now. How many times are we multiplying 3 by itself? Isn't it 5 times? So here it's 3 power 5. So here we can conclude a rule: when we have same base between them times, it means we should add the powers. 2 plus 3, we can add it directly. It gives us power 5. So same base between them times, add the powers. The general form of this rule is a power m times a power n. It gives us a power m plus n. We can write it directly, 5 power 2 times 5 power 10, for example, is 5 power 2 plus 10 equals 5 power 12. In general, x power 4, for example, times x power 6 equals x power 4 plus 6 gives us x power 10. What about divided by? If we have same base between them divided. For example, 7 power 5 over 7 power 3. What does it mean? In general, 7 power 5, it means 7 times 7, 5 times. Also, 7 power 3 is 7 times 7 times 7, 3 times. Well, as a fraction, we are having also times. Can't we simplify 7 by 7? How many 7s did we simplify? 3 7s out of 5. What remained for us? 2 7s multiplied by themselves, so it's 7 power 2. Well, here we can say that we have simplified 3 out of 5, so it's 7 power 5 minus 3. We have subtracted 3 out of 5. What remained for us? 7 power 2. So same base, between them divided, we subtract the powers. So here we can write the general form of this rule, a power m over a power n is equal a power m minus n. So for example, 10 power 7 over 10 power 3, we can write it directly as 10 power 7 minus 3. We subtract directly the powers, so it's 10 power 4. Also here, 3 power 9 over 3 power 4 is 3 power 9 minus 4. It gives us 3 power 5. So in general, we can apply the rule directly, same base, divided by, we subtracted the powers. Also here, 5 power 10 over 5 power 7 is 5 power 10 minus 7, so it's 5 power 3. The same here, but the last one, if you know something, 7 power 4 over 7, isn't it here 7 power 1? Any number that doesn't carry an exponent, its power is 1. So it's 7 power 4 over 7 power 1, we can say it's 7 power 4 minus 1 equals 7 power 3. Now let's move to more important examples. If we have it, for example, 3 times 3 power 3 over 3 power 2, how to solve it? We can solve the numerator alone, then we can solve all of it. Here, as you see, 3 is the same as 3 power 1. Same base between them times, we can add the power, so it's 3 power 1 plus 3, so it's 3 power 4. We copy the denominator, 3 power 2, the same. Now we have same base between them divided by, we can directly subtract the power, so it's 3 power 4 minus 2 equals 3 power 3. What about this example? As you see, we can solve it by two different methods. We can either solve the numerators having same base between them times add the powers, denominators same base between them times add the powers, then we solve the numerator with denominator, or we can solve each one alone here, 2 power 10 minus 4 times 2 power 5 minus 3 times 2 power 8 minus 7, since we are having same base on each side between them divided by. Now we can solve it, it's 2 power 6 times 2 power 2 times 2 power 1, same base between them times, we can add the powers, we will get the same answer here, is 2 power 9. Both methods are correct. Now let's move to more complicated examples. What happens if we don't have the same base? There are two conditions, same base between them times or divided. We can have times or divided, but we can have different bases. Some bases, we can transform them into the same base and then apply the rule of power. For example, we have 4 is 2 square, 8 is 2 cube, 16 is 2 power 4, 9, 3 power 2, 27, 3 cubed, 25, 5 squared, and 125 is 5 cubed. If we have some of these bases, we can transform into same base and then apply the rule of power. Here are some examples, 16 times 2 cubed times 2 power 8. If we want to transform them into the same base carrying one exponent, we can replace this 16 by 2 power 4. So it's 2 power 4 times 2 power 3 times 2 power 8. We have same bases between them times. Now we can directly add the powers, 4 plus 3 plus 8, so we get a 2 power 15. Another example, 9 times 3 times 3 power 7. 9, we can replace it by 3 square. Also here, 3 is 3 power 1. Then we have same bases between them times. We can directly add the powers. What happens? The same here, if we have divided by 125, we can write it as 5 power 3. So here we can subtract the power since we are having same base between them divided by. So it's 5 power 7 minus 3 gives us 5 power 4. Finally, we have 2 power 9 over 8. We can write it as 2 power 3, so it's 2 power 9 over 2 power 3. Same base between them divided, we can subtract the power, so it's 2 power 6. Here are some more examples that are very important, more complicated applications. As you see, we have 8 times 2 power 4 over 2 power 6 times 4. We can replace 8 by 2 cubed and then solve the numerator alone. We have same base between them times. We add the powers and also the denominator alone. Same base between them times. We can add the powers. So it's 2 power 3 plus 4 over 2 power 6 plus 2 is 2 power 7 over 2 power 8. Here we can subtract the power. So it's 2 power 7 minus 8 equals 2 power minus 1. Well, as you see, we have a negative exponent. Is it possible? This is what we are going to talk about it later and the other rules. Now, let's continue by our examples here. 5 times 5 power 4 over 125. As you see, 5 is 5 power 1. Same base between them times we can add the powers. Here 125 is 5 power 3. We can replace it by 5 power 3. Now we can apply the rules of power here. Same base, we add powers. 5 power 5 over 5 power 3. Here same base between them divided. Now we subtract the power, so it's 5 minus 3 is 5 power 2. The same in the last example. Now let's move to another rule which is very important. Well, as you see, it's so similar to the rule when we have same base between them divided by, but there's some difference. If you know something, we have the same exponent. Well, 7 power 3 over 7 power 3, here we can simplify it directly, it's equal to 1, or we can write 7 power 3 is 7 times 7 times 7, 3 times on each of the numerator and denominator. Now we can simplify 7 by 7 for each one. We get nothing, so the answer is 1. When we simplify and nothing remains and divided by, the answer is 1. Why did we write this rule? We want to compare it by the rule of power. If we have same base and between them divided by, shouldn't we subtract the powers? Shouldn't it be 7 power 3 minus 3? So it's 7 power 0. Note for the same example, we are having two solutions. One of them gave us the answer 1 and the other gave us the answer 0. Here we should get the rule. 7 power 0 is equal to 1. These two answers are for the same question. They are equal to each other. As a general form, we have a rule. For a to the power 0, any number raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. Sure, we have a condition. This number is different from 0 since we cannot divide by 0. Well, example, 10 power 0 equals 1. We can write it directly. 5 power 0 equals 1. 100 power 0 equals 1. Any number raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. Well, here is also another rule that is very important. In general, we have a rule 1 over a to the power m equals a to the power minus m. Sure, a should be different from 0. We cannot divide by 0. Well, how this rule comes? First of all, to understand it, when we have a power in the denominator, if we want to move it to the numerator, we should reverse the sign of the exponent. Here it's plus 5, it becomes minus 5. So 1 over 10 power 5 equals 10 power minus 5. 1 over 3 power 7, for example, equals 3 power minus 7. 1 over 5 power minus 6 equals 5 power plus 6. Here the exponent is negative. When we move the power to the numerator, it becomes having a positive exponent. Well, now we're going to prove this rule. How did we get it? Let's take an example together. If we have 1 over 5 power 4, well, can't we replace 1 by a power 0? We have just proved the rule. Well, but if we want to get same base, we can replace it by 5 power 0. How it comes? In order to have the same base between them divided by, here we can subtract the powers. As if it's 5 power 0 minus 4, so it gives us 5 power minus 4. This is the proof of our rule. Another example, 1 over 7 power 2, we can replace 1 by a power 0. We need here the base 7 in order to get same base between them divided by, so we can replace it by 7 power 0 over 7 power 2 is equal 7 power 0 minus 2, so it's 7 power minus 2. Here another example, 1 over 2 power minus 5, to get same base we replace 1 by 2 power 0. So it's 2 power 0 over 2 power minus 5, same base between them divided by, we can subtract the powers. So it's 2 power 0 minus 5. Here since we have two signs next to each other, we put the next one between parentheses. Now we multiply the signs to remove parentheses. So minus signs minus plus. So 0 plus 5 gives us 2 power plus 5. Here we have some examples that prove for us our rule. So here a power 0 over a power m, a power 0 minus m gives us a power minus m. Well, should we follow these steps at any time? No. we can directly apply our rule. We can write it 1 over 7 power 4 equals 7 power minus 4. For example, 1 over 10 power minus 2 equals 1 over 10 power minus 2 equals 10 power plus 2. We directly reverse the sign of the power. Well, now we're going to solve more complicated examples. If we have, for example, 1 over 16 times 2 power 5, first, to get same base, we can replace 16 by 2 power 4. So 1 over 2 power 4 times 2 power 5 gives us 1 over 2 power 4 plus 5. So it's here 1 over 2 power 9 gives us 2 power minus 9. Here we have transformed them into a base carrying one exponent in the denominator. Now to move it to the numerator, we just reverse the sign of this power. 1 over 5 times 5 power 4 times 125 times 376 minus 7 square all power 0. This is an important example. Here as you see, 1 over, we have same base between them times we should add the powers. 5 is as 5 power 1. What about this one? 125, we can replace it by 5 power 3 to get the same base. What about this one? We cannot transform into same base. But if you note, it's power 0. Any number, whatever it was, sure, it should be different from 0. If it's raised to the power 0, then it will be equal to 1. So we can replace all of this by 1. So here it's 1 over 5 power 1 times 5 power 4 times 125, which is 5 power 3 times, here it's a trick, we can write it directly 1 since it's raised to the power 0. Well, now if we have it multiplied by 1, so it remains the same. We just have to solve the denominator. So it's 1 over 5 power 1 plus 4 times 5 power 3. Now we can add the power, so it's 1 over 5 power 5 times 5 power 3. We can write it as 5 power minus 5 times 5 power 3, same base between them times we can add the power, so it's 5 power minus 5 plus 3 gives us 5 power minus 2. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share and subscribe. In the next video, we're going to talk about more important rules for powers with applications.